That's what, Nikhil, we are going to talk about, right? What are the ways you can, what are the steps you should follow to apply for a job or to get a job in Germany? You don't need any XYZ person in picture, and you don't need to be worried about the visa formalities. I mean, you can do everything on your own. That's what we are going to talk about here. Hi everyone, this is Manoj, your German coach. So as we discussed earlier, that I am going to connect you to one person from Germany, Nikhil Kamath, who I get in touch with him over LinkedIn. So Nikhil is basically in Germany. He is a language expert and working with a German company in Germany itself. So I got to know him through LinkedIn, and he has some important messages to deliver. Like he is what he wants to deliver here, and what we are going to discuss on this platform. How can you get a job in Germany, and that is without anybody's intervention? That's what, Nikhil, we are going to talk about, right? What are the ways you can, what are the steps you should follow to apply for a job or to get a job in Germany? You don't need any XYZ person in picture, and you don't need to be worried about the visa formalities. I mean, you can do everything on your own. That's what we are going to talk about here. Is it correct, Nikhil?
Yeah, exactly. So I would like, can I start with my background, Manoj? Is that okay?
Of course, yes. One, I should have asked about your introduction initially. So first of all, Nikhil, I welcome you to this platform.
Thank you.
And willkommen dir hier. Und ich würde gerne dich kurz bitten, wenn du dich kurz vorstellen kannst auf Deutsch, ne? Damit die Lernenden auch wissen können, ob du wirklich Deutsch sprichst.
Ja, auf jeden Fall. Dankeschön für die Einladung, und ich freue mich, hier zu sein und ein bisschen auch auf Deutsch zu sprechen. So, also ich bin Nikhil und ich bin 26 Jahre alt, und ich komme aus einem kleinen Dorf in Südwestküste von Indien. Also ich bin da geboren, und ich hatte auch meinen Uni-Abschluss da gemacht, und dann habe ich erst einen Job in Bangalore gefunden, bei Accenture war das. Und ich habe dort für 2 Jahre gearbeitet, und dann habe ich auch bei Mercedes-Benz für kurz 1 Jahr gearbeitet. Und dann war, ja, hat ich habe angefangen mit Jobsuche, mit der Jobsuche in Deutschland. Und ja, ich würde sagen, das war erfolgreich, und jetzt bin ich hier seit 3 Monaten. So,
how did you do that? You got a good job in Germany. How did you do that? This is what the learners are curious to know. How, because in India, what learners basically are worried about, they do certain level of German, then
yes,
they apply for a job, they don't get responses from the companies. What exactly have you done that you got this job?
Exactly to say, so I would say German was a really a great tool for me. So without mm-hmm. German, I would say it is not impossible. Like, it's not impossible without German. No, it's false. So, but German will naturally will increase your chances of getting a job. So I would say German is one of the strongest tool if you have, and then comes your technical skills for sure. So what I would say is, like, try to start doing, like, you finish your bachelor's. I will start from basic. So you uh-huh. finish your bachelor's, and you get into a company. So what the people who have just finished their bachelor's, I would say, start learning the language. So parallel with doing your technical skills, where with polishing your technical skills, start learning the language. So okay, that would definitely help. So, and for the people, for long run, if you have 7-6 years of experience in certain technical field already, yeah, so yeah, the thing is, you need to find jobs in major big cities like Munich, Berlin, and maybe Hamburg. So yeah, these places will definitely have a job, and they are more international, and you will definitely have a job where you need not speak German every day. So only your technical roles play a major role. So yeah, that's one of the tip what I would give as a, for just for a beginning introduction. But yeah, it goes deeper and deeper for sure. Manoj,
Okay,
yeah.
so are there any websites like we have Monster, Zing, Naukri to search for a job in Germany, or people have to visit Germany for a job seeker visa and then hunt for a job?
I would say during this time, I would never risk myself to go for a job search visa JSV, because I don't think if it's open now, so I'm not pretty sure. But when I was coming, it was not at all open. So
Okay.
and coming here, and you should have you should leave your job which you have in India and then come here and search for a job. I feel that's a quite risky thing what I would do during the Corona times, because people will never want you to be inside the office to give you interview, because you are from India, and it's like you don't have a lot of time as well. So because of this
Correct.
Delta variant, they would
Correct.
always avoid you, your contact. So if it is a Skype meeting, you can do it from India. So I would say never risk for job search visas, but do it from India. So, but there are a lot of websites. So as you mentioned, Zing is one of the main websites which attracts all the German the market workplace. So it's like it's for Austria, Switzerland and Germany, the three places, and
Oh,
Zing is one of the top it's a top
so it's
social media for job market. So I would say, so secondly,
okay.
I would go for Indeed. Indeed is one of the major where you can find all the insights.
Okay.
From region to region, you can filter all the regions, Hanover, Berlin, or Hamburg. You can filter the cities, and a lot of jobs are posted there, because I think it's a little bit cheaper to post jobs for the people than LinkedIn, what I have heard. And another thing is Bundesagentur. So that's one of the very important websites. But as I say, every job description will be in German. So it's always better
You
you
need to
know
have
German.
that expertise. Yes,
Yeah.
yes.
You need.
And how do you spell it? It's xing punct dot da de,
Yeah,
right? That's
zing
Zing.
punct de.
Okay,
Yeah,
okay.
exactly.
And
Then
what
you have
kind of
Indeed.
jobs? Indeed is one there. And what kind of jobs people can find on Zing or Indeed or?
I would say all kind of technical jobs, and also some management, business analyst kind of jobs.
Okay.
Even so, yeah. You just filter based on just get the keyword, what it actually means in German. For example, my job was support engineer. I would say Anwendungsbetreuer, Anwendung support, something like that. So just get the keyword for German equivalent and just start searching. So you would definitely get something, some more results based on this. So, but the best website is the Bundesagentur. So, you can post it on the description, in the description, maybe. I would send you later. So, and here it's like each city will have at least 100, no, 50 jobs for sure. So, So, I just spoke to a friend who works in Accenture, and he said, so yearly there are about 1,500 jobs. Sorry, not 100,000 jobs which are not filled in Germany for IT branch,
Nice,
and
nice.
they need more IT people. And it's like the inverted triangle. So there are a lot of old people here, and the young people are very little bit
Right.
less in number. So they need young resources
young
who can
people
you can work
so
and bring taxes to the nation for sure. So yeah.
And it's only for the IT experts, or people like me who have nothing to do with IT can also find job?
I would say IT is the trending one, but there are
SAP
people
is
who
also
have found
one of the most popular job area. SAP
which
folks,
one?
SAP folks.
Ah, SAP.
So
SAP is here in South, so it's in near Heidelberg. So they have
right.
They have very big plant. I mean, the company is a lot big. The headquarters is in Waldorf, that's in south of Germany. And all the automobile firms are here. So automobile, I would not say it's only mechanical engineers. There are a lot of IT openings in automobile. So even my client is of automobile. So I work for Volkswagen. So you definitely have, when it's automobile, parallelly you have some IT there. So there are a lot of openings for IT too.
Okay, so that means anyone who wish to get a job in Germany should first start learning German. And what is the minimum expertise German companies look for?
They would not look for expert like any certificate. I was never asked for certificate. So what they expect is you speak and understand what they speak. So,
but that is not going to run, not going to be done, because you know, you need to have a certificate. You okay. got lucky. You got lucky. Without certification, you got a job. But generally, it's not going to happen. That's what I believe.
Yeah,
that's what
I would say. I heard from a friend of mine. It's B2. B2 is the one for Accenture. It's B2. Maybe some companies ask, some companies don't. Some yeah.
Okay.
Definitely,
okay.
the
but
interview
is the minimum.
Will be in German.
B2 is the minimum.
Yeah, B2 will be minimum. I would say because you need to contact with clients. Sometimes you need to take requirements. If you are even a developer, you should speak sometimes.
So my first criteria is met. I learned language. I found a trainer. I started learning within 6 months or 8 months or 10 months of time. I am okay to speak. I get certificate. My next step is to check which area I want to get a job in. I want to work in a restaurant. I want to work in McDonald's. I want to work with a company as an employee. This is the second step. Third, then find out the correct platform, which you just mentioned here. It is Zing, Indeed. Bundesagentur, and what was the fourth one you were just mentioning?
What was that? Zinc.
Zinc.
LinkedIn. You can find also in LinkedIn for sure.
LinkedIn. Okay, you can find out. Once you find out a job, you can contact the employer. Employer reverts back on mail. You can directly, you know, you can fix up an appointment or a meeting or an online interview, because nowadays everything is happening online. When they finalize you, they say, okay, you're good to go for a job. Then what is the next step? How can I apply for the visa? At least for this, I need someone to help me.
Yeah, definitely. So in Germany, what majorly depends is your work contract. So once you get a work contract, it's called Arbeitsvertrag. So, right. And here you should have a minimum for IT, it's like 55,000 euro per annum. So normally people will, your employer will give you this but much of salary, your brutto salary. It's like without deduction of taxes. Right. So definitely you will get this salary. And if you get this and just apply for your employer, a blue card visa in any of your consulates, nearby
so
consulates.
I can directly apply at the German consulate in Delhi, in German embassy
exactly.
in Delhi. Directly
yeah.
go.
If you have...
Which
no, you just apply it online. You apply it
so
online.
You can apply online. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you get an appointment.
Okay. And what are the documents which company, which embassy ask for? It's my basic KYC.
Yes. Your passport.
Passport, yeah. Educational certificates, language certificates, and the work contract. Nothing else.
Yeah. And your course which you done, your bachelor should be recognizable in one of the websites called Anabin. So... Okay. So yeah, it's very important. So it's like all the universities are there almost. So you just, your bachelor's or your master's, what you did, your previous qualification should be recognized. It should be listed in this website. So
wonderful. Wonderful, Nikhil. This is, you know, really helpful. So the people I meet every day, or let's say whenever I meet someone who wishes to go to Germany, they are simply like panicked a lot. How to apply, which consultant to check with, which one to follow, how to do that. So the steps which you mentioned to get a job, these are very simple. I mean, people were not aware of these things, that they can directly apply for a job in Germany, any sector they wish to work
exactly,
in.
Exactly.
Right, right. Very, it's very useful, Nikhil. And I really thankful to you for your time and, you know, your initiative. You wanted to, you know, connect on this platform and inform everyone.
And it's not only me. I know many colleagues who did this. So it was like, I did it after knowing that I can do this.
Wonderful. Yeah. Wonderful. It's going to be really good support, Nikhil, to be very honest. And which
so
level
another
have you
thing
done?
Which I would go to, like add to the previous point, which we said, so is like when you go into the job description of each job, so there will be a number mentioned. So okay. of HR, the point Ansprechpartner or the point of contact. So
right.
you just add few Skype credits. So you can do international call, just call the number and ask whether you need international candidates. So some might reject, some then don't apply there. So it's nothing wrong. You can call anybody there since they have mentioned this number. I did it many times. So there is nothing wrong just calling them and asking, if I'm from India, I have this qualification, I deserve this much of experience, can I apply? Will this go or not? So yeah, you get more clear idea. So I have done this. So.
Wonderful, wonderful, Nikhil. Thank you very much for your time, Nikhil. And what is your language certification, if I may ask? You have not done any
I have
certification.
B1. I have B1.
And you speak so fluent German. The kind of pronunciation you have is very good. I mean, I'm really glad to see you. Like people like you, like after B1, you have very strong. For how long you have been learning?
I've been learning for 3 years, maybe.
Wow. Any tip you would like to give to my learners that they don't feel demotivated after B1, they have an opportunity to work in Germany?
Yeah, definitely. So I would say watch more YouTube. So yeah, watch a lot and lot. Like what is like I did was I used to love traveling. So I watched these travel logs and everything is German. So cooking, everything German. So.
Wow.
Yeah, it interests me because I like the topic and I learn the vocabulary in this. Yeah, that is a disadvantage, but at the same time, I learn something which is interesting and talk to more people like the native speakers. So I worked in an NGO in India back and I have a lot of German friends there. So even my midway owner now is a German. So
which city you are in?
I'm in Hannover. Hannover.
Ah, okay. Wonderful.
Yeah,
wonderful.
They speak Hochdeutsch here.
I was in Köln in 2011.
Okay, Köln is out and not very far from, 2 hours from in ICE.
I have been to Cologne, I have been to Wuppertal, Berlin,
Wuppertal.
Yeah, these are the places I have been to, and perhaps I'm coming this year.
We will definitely meet then.
Thank you, Nikhil, for your time, and thank you for your information. First of all, very, very appreciated. And please share the link, whatever you are giving us here. I will put the links under the video description so that learners can use the link for their references.
Exactly. They can contact me on LinkedIn or Instagram or anywhere. So if they find me somewhere, but it might take time, but I might reply. I will reply for sure.
So you guys, you can find Nikhil Kamath over LinkedIn. His name is Nikhil, N-I-K-H-I-L, Nikhil Kamath, K-A-M-A-T-H. You can find him over LinkedIn and ask him anything you want to ask. Okay. These kind of people are really humble and I really know they're very rare to be found. It's my pleasure that I have Nikhil on this platform and he's coming to, tell us the steps. Very nice, Nikhil. Thank you very much, Nikhil, once again. And I really wish you a wonderful rest of the day and a beautiful weekend ahead, Nikhil.
You too. Thank you. All the best, guys.